Hey, it's Patti Scharf, CPA and co-founder of Catching Clouds, a leader in e-commerce accounting. Today, I want to give you an example about how to project out your cash flow. On Saturday, I gave you a video and talked about why it's important to be tracking your cash flow and keeping an eye on that going forward. If you missed that video, you can see it right here. But let's just jump in and get started. All right, so you can do this in Excel, you can do it in Google Sheets, and it's really, really simple. All you do is you have your, any day that you've got a bank that is open, you're gonna have a changing bank balance because you're gonna be having money coming in, you're gonna have money going out, and that's all we're looking at. Today is September 3rd, and we're gonna look out ahead for 4 weeks. You can do this for 30 days, you can do it for 4 weeks, you can do it for 2 weeks, you can do it for 60 days, whatever works for you, okay? And what you're gonna do is you're gonna have one section for cash coming in, so those are gonna be deposits into your bank account, and you're gonna have a section for cash going out, so that's gonna be stuff that's going out. And then at the end of the day, you'll have your ending bank balance. You'll see that becomes your new balance for the next day and so on and so forth. And you just kind of keep going forward. So I like to have a little bit more detail in here. So for your cash coming in, you'll keep track of things like Amazon deposits. So let's say that you've got an Amazon, you're selling on Amazon, you're getting your Amazon seller deposit once every 2 weeks. You would just find out when you're expecting that deposit, and every couple of weeks, you throw it in there, okay? AR collections, this is gonna be, you invoiced somebody, they're paying you on terms, and you're kind of estimating when you're gonna get the check. You call up your customer and say, hey, when are you gonna pay me? And they say, hey, you'll have a check by Friday, then you can throw that number into your cash flow projection, okay? PayPal transfers, Stripe, anything else that's coming in, you can just include on there to show your cash coming into your account, okay? Then you have another section for cash out. This is gonna include things like money that you're taking out personally, an owner distribution, or it's gonna include payroll or your sales tax payments, your payroll tax payments, any auto draft payments that are gonna come out of your account automatically through ACH. Any of your monthly bills when you're paying a lump of bills every few weeks or something like that. And then any credit card payments, basically anything that you're planning on using the money that's in your checking account for, okay? And then you can just go through and fill all this out. In my example, I want everything to be entered as a positive so that I don't accidentally forget to use a negative, and then I have, like, if I had negative $250 and I put it in as a positive number, it would like actually add it in there and it would throw everything off. So I like to put these in as positive numbers so that these numbers down here are all formulaic and you don't screw stuff up, okay? So let's say you've got $30,000 in your bank account and you say, hey, I don't need $30,000 in my bank account. I'm gonna take $20,000 out and stick it in my savings account. You can see that when you do that, oops, remember what I just said? You can see when you do that, that you're gonna run out of money in just a week and a half. So, no, maybe we shouldn't do that. Okay, yeah, 1,000 I can save, you know? So all you're trying to do is just make sure that when you've got payments coming up, say you're gonna purchase some new inventory or something like that, you just want to make sure that you have the cash flow sufficient. Because one of the biggest reasons that businesses go out of business is due to cash flow, not due to lack of profitability, all right? So this is how you do it on a day-by-day basis. I would recommend if you're just running the ragged edge, that you do this and just make sure that you're staying on top of things. I would also say you may want to make sure that you're pulling out money for savings as much as possible. If you haven't seen my video on Profit First, maybe check that out. That might help you as well. Okay, so that is the daily cash flow. You'll also want to do something like a 3-month cash flow. So you'll see how this has lots of details on it. I probably wouldn't do that for a multiple month cash flow because you just aren't entirely sure what's going to come out and when, but you can get estimates. So let's say you've got some accounts receivable. So you've sent out invoices to people. Let's say you have $50,000 worth of invoices. And usually, historically speaking, you collect 80% within 30 days, then you'll know roughly how much money is going to come in based on just that knowledge of your business, okay? And it's really straightforward. You just start with your starting balance, estimate how much you're going to collect, estimate how much you're going to need for money going out based on how much you spend each month on payroll, how much you spend for rent, so on and so forth, to come up with your ending bank balance. And you just want to make sure you've got enough money to cover the bills. That's basically how it goes. So it doesn't need to be complicated. This should be really straightforward. If you have any other questions or comments or tricks that have helped you, make sure you include them in the comments down below. I hope this video helped you. If you did, please like, comment, and share. If you haven't already, please subscribe, and I'll catch you later.